Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan. Through this video lecture, I am going to discuss with you the subject gas dynamics and jet propulsion, which is in the sixth semester elective paper for the Anna University curriculum. This is lecture number zero. So here we are going to review the fluid mechanics and the thermodynamics fundamentals. So the subject gas dynamics require the knowledge on fluid mechanics and thermodynamics. So the prerequisite for the subject is fluid mechanics and thermodynamics. So we revise some of the important parameters in the two subjects. So, fluid is basically defined as a substance which deforms continuously under the action of shearing force. Any substance in the, any matter or the substance can exist in either in the solid state or in the fluid state. So, fluid is basically a substance which is continuously deforming even for a minimum shear stress. And this fluid is classified into two. One is liquid, another one is gas. So liquid, it is very difficult to compress. So it may be regarded as an incompressible fluid. So we call the liquid as incompressible fluid. The given mass of the liquid occupies a fixed volume, irrespective of the size and shape of the container. So you take a small quantity of water and put it in a vessel. So the water will take the shape of the vessel. And if the water quantity is less than the volume of the container, so there will be a free surface at the top. So the free surface is formed if the volume of the container is greater than the liquid. So the liquid, it is very difficult to compress and it is called as incompressible fluid. It occupies, it will take the shape of the container and it will form a free surface at the top if the volume of the container is greater than the volume of the liquid. On the other hand, gas, which is the subject or the fluid which we are going to deal with the subject, the gas is compressible. So the compressible fluid flow, that is what gas dynamics. So compressible gas is a compressible, and the given mass of the gas, there is no fixed volume, it will expand continuously and adjust to fill the container completely. So you take any vessel and put some amount of gas inside the vessel. So the gas will expand to the entire volume of the vessel. So there is no free surface formed in the case of gas. And we will take fluid properties, the basic fluid properties. For the first property is density. So density defined as the mass per unit volume. So rho is mass by volume, which is in kilograms per meter cube. And the second property is specific weight. Specific weight is defined as weight per unit volume. So weight by volume equal to m into g. The weight equal to m into g, mass into acceleration due to gravity divided by volume, which is in Newton per meter cube. And specific volume is defined as the volume per unit mass, which is reciprocal of the density. Volume by mass equal to v by m equal to the reciprocal of the density, which is specific volume. The unit is meter cube per kilogram. And the viscosity. The resistance, how will you define the viscosity? The resistance offered by shearing motion of fluid is termed as viscosity. We assume number of layers. So you take a container or a canal where the water is flowing. We assume number of layers of water is flowing from bottom of the canal to the top of the water layer. And each layer, we assume each layer, number of layers, each layer offers resistance for the adjacent layer of the fluid. So Newton postulated that the shearing stress produced by relative motion of the fluid layer is directly proportional to the velocity gradient in the direction normal to the plane. So the velocity gradient is dou u by dou y. So shear stress is tau. So tau, the shear stress is proportional to dou u by dou y. And we introduce a constant to remove the proportionality, that is mu. So the constant of viscosity is termed as coefficient of viscosity, absolute viscosity, or dynamic viscosity. So mu is coefficient of viscosity, or absolute viscosity, or dynamic viscosity. Where u is the velocity of the parallel to the wall, and y is the coordinate normal to it, and dynamic viscosity mu is measured in Newton second by meter square. And the kinematic viscosity, another term, is defined as the ratio of dynamic viscosity and the fluid density measured in meter square per second. So nu is dynamic viscosity divided by density, mu by rho, which is in meter square per second. So the viscosity of the liquid decreases with the temperature, but for the gases it increases with the temperature. But what we are going to do, for many of the applications considered in this subject, the effect of viscosity is negligible. So anyhow, we should know what is viscosity and dynamic viscosity and the kinematic viscosity. And the pressure, it is defined as the force exerted per unit area, so which is in newtons per meter square or pascal. And we have two types of pressure, positive pressure, negative pressure. Positive pressure is pressure above the atmospheric pressure. Negative pressure is pressure below the atmospheric pressure. And we define the absolute pressure, which is the sum of, for the positive pressure, which is sum of gauge pressure and the atmospheric pressure. So gauge pressure is the pressure indicated by any pressure gauge with reference to the atmospheric pressure. Whereas for absolute pressure, the reference is zero pressure. For negative pressure, absolute pressure equal to, it is atmospheric pressure minus the gauge pressure. And this diagram will explain you the different types of pressure. So actually you take the pressure in the y-axis, and you look at here, this is the line for atmospheric pressure. Anything below the atmospheric pressure is negative pressure or the vacuum pressure. Anything above the atmospheric pressure is positive pressure. So the for positive pressure, so the absolute pressure is the sum of the height atmospheric pressure plus the gauge pressure. So the gauge pressure is measured above the, with reference to the atmospheric pressure. For negative pressure, so the absolute pressure is atmospheric pressure minus the gauge pressure, which is referred as vacuum pressure. So the pressure below the atmospheric pressure is always referred as vacuum pressure. So positive absolute pressure, gauge pressure, and atmospheric pressure, these are all the terminology we have to remember. And the compressibility. Compressibility, so this is compressible fluid flow, gas dynamics. So compressibility of the fluid is characteristic of the fluid, indicates its ability to change its volume under pressure. So relative change of volume per unit pressure is given by the coefficient of compressibility, beta equal to minus 1 by V into dV by dP. So the change in volume with respect to pressure, that is what the compressibility. And dP is a small change in the pressure applied to the fluid, and dV is the incremental volume change in the original volume. Now we define another parameter called the bulk modulus of elasticity, is the inverse of the compressibility. So the bulk modulus of elasticity is measure of compressive stress per unit volume strain. So K equal to 1 by beta, which is minus dP by dV by V. So dV by V is the volume strain, and dP is the compressive stress or change in the pressure. Velocity of the fluid. Velocity of fluid is a vector quantity. The fluid velocity at any given point is instantaneous velocity of the fluid particle passing through the point. The unit of fluid velocity is meters per second. And we have the velocity of the sound. Velocity of the sound is defined as velocity at which very weak pressure wave are transmitted through the gases. So A is given by square root of gamma R into T. So velocity of sound. So this terminology is very much required for gas dynamics. Velocity of sound A equal to square root of gamma R into T, where gamma is the constant for air 1.4, R equal to 287, and T is the temperature. For example, the velocity of sound of air, velocity of sound in air at 0 degree Celsius is 331 meters per second. Then the types of fluid flow. First is incompressible fluid flow and compressible fluid flow. The flow is said to be incompressible if the relative change in density of the fluid in the process is negligible, small. All liquids are incompressible, so we cannot compress the fluid. Then the compressible flow, for compressible flow, there is appreciable change in the density of the fluid during the process, during the compression process. So that is called as compressible fluid. All gases and air are compressible flow. Steady flow and unsteady flow. For steady flow, the fluid properties do not change with respect to time within the control volume. For unsteady flow, the fluid properties change with respect to time within the control volume. So normally we assume steady flow for theoretical calculation, but practically the flow is unsteady flow. Laminar flow, when the fluid particle move in parallel lines in an orderly manner and retain the relative motion in the successive cross section is called as laminar flow. And this is also theoretical, but the practical flow is turbulent flow. So when the fluid particle exhibits small fluctuation in the magnitude and direction of the velocity accompanied by a small pressure fluctuation is called as turbulent flow. So the fluid particles are moving in a random fashion in the case of a turbulent flow. The next one is friction coefficient, so which is defined F equal to shear stress, wall shear stress divided by 1 by 2 rho c square, and T tau w is wall shear stress, and the friction factor is the measure of frictional resistance for the flow. So this is also a very important parameter in the gas dynamics. And for laminar flow, F equal to 64 by Reynolds number, and for fully developed turbulent flow, the friction factor F equal to 0.0306 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.143, where RE is the Reynolds number. And here we stop, we take a break. Here I have a reflection spot. So you take few seconds and recall and rewrite down the important points that you remember from the previous 10 minutes lecture. So if you are able to write all these things, fluid properties like density, specific volume, specific weight, viscosity, kinematic viscosity, dynamic viscosity, compressibility, bulk modulus elasticity, velocity of the fluid, velocity of the sound, types of fluid flow like the steady flow, unsteady flow, incompressible flow, compressible flow, laminar flow and turbulent flow, it is good. You are good and you are listening very accurately the lecture. I congratulate you. Then we take up the thermodynamics fundamentals. First, the system. So thermodynamics, it is talking about it. In this subject, we studied in the third semester, where energy and its interaction. So the major two sources of energy, which we are interested in thermodynamics, was heat and the work. So the mutual interaction between heat and work were studied in thermodynamics. So first we start with the system. System is the space we select for our thermodynamic study, and the system may be open system, closed system, or the isolated system. So open system, both mass and energy crosses the boundaries of the system, whereas closed system, only energy is crossing the boundary, mass remains constant. Isolated system is not reacting, is not interacting with the surrounding. So it is isolated from the surrounding. And we have the control volume and control surface. So though there are open system and closed system, practically all the devices, all the equipment are open system. For example, air compressor, your fan, an IC engine, a heat exchanger, all these devices are open system. For open system, we go in closer, we take control volume and control surface. So the space, the device volume of the device is called as control volume, And the control surface is the surface which separates the volume or the device from the rest of the world or from the surrounding is called as control surface. And we take state, process and the cycle. So the state is the specification. So we take thermodynamic property. If you define, for example, atmospheric state. Atmospheric state is 1.01325 bar. So the pressure at atmospheric condition and temperature, atmospheric temperature is take 35 degrees Celsius. So that is the atmospheric state. So any, if the thermodynamic property, the basic thermodynamic property, pressure, volume and temperature takes a numerical value, a specific numerical value, then the fluid is called at a particular state. Then it, if it undergoes a process, so if this process, the state properties are changing. So process, it is causing the change of state. And the fluid undergoes different processes and returns to the original state, it is called a cycle, thermodynamic cycle. So for example, what you discussed earlier, Barrett-Arnold cycle, Otto cycle, Bell-Coleman cycle, these are all the thermodynamic cycle where the fluid undergoes different processes and returns back to the original state. And the thermodynamic equilibrium, we have three equilibrium: thermal equilibrium, chemical equilibrium, and mechanical equilibrium. So thermal equilibrium, there is no change in the temperature. The system is in thermal equal temperature. That is what thermal equilibrium. Mechanical equilibrium, the system, there is no unbalanced forces in the system. That is what mechanical equilibrium. And the chemical equilibrium, there is no chemical reaction within the system. That is what chemical equilibrium. When the mechanical, thermal and the chemical equilibrium conditions are satisfied, then it is called as thermodynamic equilibrium. System is in the thermodynamic equilibrium. And the zeroth law of thermodynamics proposed by H. Fowler in 1931, which states that when the system A is in thermal equilibrium with B and C separately, then they are all in thermal equilibrium. That is what the zeroth law of thermodynamics, that is the basic for temperature measurement. So the temperature measurement is based on the zeroth law of thermodynamics, and we have different scales for temperature measurement: Fahrenheit scale, Celsius scale, and Rankine scale. So what is very popular is Fahrenheit and Celsius scale, Kelvin scale. So this table shows the conversion factor. So normally we take Kelvin, temperature in Kelvin, which is degree Celsius plus 273.15 exactly, or degree Celsius plus 273 roughly, and the heat and the work. So both are forms of energy. Heat and work, they are forms of energy. They are mutually convertible. So when the heat is applied to the system, work is produced, or when the work is given to the system, heat is produced. And there are some sign convention. When heat is applied to the system is positive, heat rejected from the system is negative, whereas work given to the system is negative, work done by the system is positive. And they are path function, they are not properties of the system. And the first law of thermodynamics, so this is in a cyclic process, net heat transfer is equal to net work transfer. That is what the first law of thermodynamics. From using the first law of thermodynamics, we identify a property called internal energy. So internal energy, Q equal to W plus delta U. That is what the mathematical form of the first law of thermodynamics. So where delta U is the change in internal energy. So using the first law of thermodynamics, we identify a property called internal energy. And we define enthalpy. Enthalpy H equal to U plus PV. So internal energy plus flow energy. P into V is the flow energy. That is what the enthalpy. And the specific heat and the heat capacity. So specific heat, the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the body by 1 degree per unit mass, per unit mass, that is what the specific heat. And heat capacity is mass into specific heat. And the liquid, they have one specific heat, solid, they have one specific heat, whereas gas, they have two specific heats: specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume. Second law of thermodynamics, there are two statements on the second law of thermodynamics. One is Kelvin-Planck statement, another in the Clausius statement. We just revise the second law of thermodynamics. Entropy is the property identified by the second law of thermodynamics. And based on the second law of thermodynamics, we classify the process into reversible process and the irreversible process. So reversible process, which the fluid will undergo on reverse of the effect, the fluid property will return to the original state following the same path. Whereas in the irreversible process, it will not occur. All the practical processes are irreversible, but theoretically we assume the processes are reversible for our thermodynamic calculation. And this is what the Clausius inequality, the condition for different process. So del Q by T is less than zero, the cycle is possible and irreversible. Del Q by T equal to zero, the cycle is possible and reversible. And del Q by T is greater than zero, the cycle is impossible. So del Q by T equal to the dS, change in entropy. And the perfect gas equation, so PV equal to MRT, or P is the pressure, V is the capital volume, M is the mass, and R is the gas constant, T is the temperature. Or PV equal to N R bar T, N is the number of moles, and R bar is the universal gas constant. Or pressure P into small v, V bar equal to R bar into T, where V bar is the molar volume, R bar is the universal gas constant. So normally we use this equation, PV equal to MRT. And this is the book what I have written on gas turbine jet propulsion. So all the lectures will be from this book. So the book you can refer for your further discussion. And for any further query, you can contact me through my mail ID. And finally, thank you.